Welcome back to our proactive London studio, where I'm talking to Tom Lamb now. He's the CEO of Myriad Uranium. And Tom, it's great to see you. How are things?
Good, thanks. I'm happy to be here. Good to see you, Tom.
It's a pleasure to have you on. Our proactive audience won't have seen you for around about 9 months now. We last heard from you back in January. You were talking to my colleague, Steve Darling. But a lot has happened since then. A little bit of a shift of emphasis for the business. Why don't you get us up to speed with what's been going on?
Yeah, so your viewers may recall that Myriad has been focused on the Tim Mersoï Uranium Basin in Niger. It's one of the world's great uranium basins. Our projects are on structure and adjacent to some of the world's best projects. Imereren, that's Africa's largest uranium deposits, the world's second largest. We're just down the fault from DASA, Global Atomics DASA, which is Africa's best uranium deposit, being advanced by Global Atomic, et cetera. We have amazing 1,800 square kilometers in Niger, and we were advancing those projects. However, in July, there was a coup in Niger, military coup, and that has paused us. And with these things, we have to usually wait 6 months or longer for these things to settle. In the interim, we have refocused, and we've refocused to Wyoming, to probably the best uranium jurisdiction in the world at the moment. U.S. government, federal, provincial, state are very supportive of uranium mining, and Wyoming is an amazing place. We've really gotten lucky. I suggest your viewers take a look at what we've done, news release, website, et cetera. We are earning up to 75% now of the Copper Mountain Uranium Project near Riverton in central Wyoming. So we thought we were earning into, when we signed the LOI, we thought we were earning into more of an exploration project. We knew there was past uranium production there. But it turns out, now that we've gone through some newly acquired data, a vast trove of newly acquired data that even the owners hadn't had a chance to look at yet. They just bought it after their 43-101. Turns out up to 2,000 drill holes in this property. Union Pacific, one of America's big companies, had advanced it over decades, spent tens of millions of dollars on it. Seven or eight uranium deposits on the property. We're going to have a very exciting go here to find tens of millions of pounds of uranium, I'm sure. I can't, for securities law purposes, I have to caveat that, et cetera. This is going to turn into something very exciting. So it's the Copper Mountain Uranium Project. It's not well known. It's all pre-internet age information. But just look out. It's going to be quite something.
We'll certainly be keeping our eyes peeled for that one, Tom. In terms of what we should actually be looking out for, what do you think will be the next thing that we hear from you about this one?
So 2 weeks ago, we signed a letter of intent. We had a 30-day due diligence period. We're working our way through everything as quickly as we can. It looks great. No guarantees, obviously, but in a couple of weeks, there should be another announcement, either that we've closed the deal or we're extending another week or two for technical reasons. But I think things are really on track. After that, we're going to be discussing all this data that we have in all the historic resource estimates that we've found, previous owners, in particular Union Pacific. They've surveyed these mineral deposits, and we have the information about them. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about their plans to mine. Union Pacific had a mine plan for one of the deposits in the center of our claims, and even built a leach pad in preparation for production. But then the Three Mile Island accident intervened end of the 70s and stopped everything in terms of uranium production. So pre-internet age, a lot of excitement, and then everything came to a halt. And that's where we are. We're picking it up where they left off.
Absolutely. And the uranium market has really been in the spotlight recently because prices have been very strong, and the outlook looks bright for it as a commodity. But just before I let you go and get back to trawling through all of that data, Tom, is there anything else you think that people might need to understand about this that perhaps they don't already?
Well, I encourage your viewers to take a look at our capital structure, 28.5 million shares outstanding. It's very tight. Management and our group own about 10 of that. Another group that's on a trickle out owns 8.5%, and it's a really nice capital structure for investors also. So I think it's presents well. You'll see, because analysts, et cetera, are going to pick this up in due course, and you'll see it's a very nice structure for investors to come into. I'd like to add that.
CEO of Myriad Uranium, Tom Lamb, it's been great to get your thoughts and all the very best with this new project.
It's a pleasure. Thank you, Tom.